Hello everyone, I welcome you all in this lecture, and in this lecture I am going to discuss some principal causes of environmental pollution. As you all know that environmental pollution is of different types like water pollution, air pollution, soil pollution, light pollution and radioactive pollution and all that. I will mainly discuss here some principal causes of water, air and soil pollution. So let's start with causes of water pollution. First one cause is improper disposal of industrial waste. Now there are different kinds of industries like chemical industries, pharmaceutical industries, textile industries. These all kinds of industries produce waste, and that waste may contain toxic chemicals, heavy metals, and which are highly hazardous for the human and other organisms' health. And when such type of waste is discharged into the water bodies without any prior treatment, then it may lead to the water pollution. That actually happens in the regions where they have no proper waste disposal system or waste management system. Here they discharge their industrial waste into the freshwater bodies as such without any treatment. So this may lead to water pollution. Now next is domestic wastewater. Waste discharged from houses may contain toxic chemicals and pathogens, and these pathogens may produce various waterborne diseases. And thus discharging of such type of waste without any prior treatment into the water bodies leads to the water pollution. Next is due to agricultural activities. In agriculture, where different chemicals are used, they use chemical pesticides, herbicides, fertilizers, etc. And when such type of agricultural soil added into the main water bodies along with the runaway water or rain water, that may lead to the water pollution, because these chemicals can increase the organic and inorganic substances into the water, and that may lead to the increase in the microbial load of the water, and microbes utilize the oxygen that is dissolved in the water bodies, and ultimately it can cause the depletion of oxygen in the water bodies, and thus agricultural activities in this way produce the pollution of water. Now next is burning of fossil fuels. Burning of fossil fuels like coal, petroleum, natural gas produce large quantities of ash and oxides of nitrogen and sulfur into the atmosphere. And these nitrogen oxides and sulfur oxides have a tendency to combine with the water vapors that are present in the atmosphere. When they combine with the water vapors and fall on the water bodies along with the rainwater, then it is termed as acid rain, and that acid rain makes the water bodies acidic and make the water unsuitable for living of aquatic organisms. Thus they produce water pollution. Now next is animals waste. Animals waste may be washed away with the rain water and may be added into the main water bodies, and that agricultural waste may contain pathogens, so it may produce various waterborne diseases like cholera, diarrhea, dysentery, typhoid, etc. Now next is global warming. Now global warming means in the atmosphere the rise in some gases like carbon dioxide, methane, chlorofluorocarbons, etc. These gases produce increase the average temperature of the atmosphere, along with the increase in temperature of the atmosphere, the average temperature of the water bodies may increase. And due to the increase in temperature, the depletion of oxygen may take place in the water bodies, and thus it may cause the death of the aquatic organisms, and thus leads to the water pollution. Now next is causes of air pollution. First one is burning of fossil fuels. Burning of fossil fuels like coal, petroleum, natural gas produce various oxides of sulfur, nitrogen, and these oxides add to the air pollution, and mostly these are emitted from the vehicles like jeeps, cars, trains, etc., and leads to addition of these harmful gases into the atmosphere, and thus the pollution of the atmosphere. Now next is agricultural activities. In the agriculture, there are different chemicals are used like pesticides, herbicides, fertilizers, etc., and these chemicals may produce vapors and can added up into the atmosphere and cause the environmental cause the atmospheric pollution. Now mainly the ammonical fertilizers may also release an hazardous gas, that is ammonia, and this is also responsible for causing atmospheric pollution. Now next is exhaust from industries and factories. The discharge from factories may contain harmful gases or other chemicals or their fumes like that of carbon dioxide, hydrocarbons, organic compounds. These all deteriorate the quality of the air, make the air unfit for breathing, and thus responsible for causing air pollution. Now next is mining operations. Mining means extraction of metals or minerals from under the earth, and in that process there may release dust and chemical substances into the atmosphere, and these chemicals and dust deteriorate the quality of the air. That may such kind of environment mainly affects the workers and persons that are living permanently in the vicinity of these mining operating areas. Now next is indoor air pollution. Inside the houses also cleaning products are used, and these cleaning products and the paints that are that has been applied on the walls may produce some fumes, and these fumes makes the atmosphere unfit for breathing, and thus pollute the indoor air. Now next is the causes of soil pollution. First one is industrial activities. As you all know that in the different kinds of industries produce waste, and that waste may contain toxic chemicals, heavy metals, and when such type of waste is disposed over the land as such without any prior treatment, it may lead to soil pollution. It may cause the deterioration of the soil health, it may cause infertility of the soil, and thus soil can become unfit for growing crops. Now next is agricultural activities. In the agriculture there are different chemicals are used like fertilizers, chemical fertilizers, pesticides, and when these are used in excess amount, then they may deteriorate the quality of the soil, and this is also termed as agrochemical pollution. And besides that, there are certain other agricultural activities are also there, like when poor aggregation methods are applied, or improper maintenance of canals, excessive watering of plants, lack of crop rotation, intensive farming, these all improper agricultural activities gradually deplete the health of the soil and make the soil unfit for growing the crops. Next is improper solid waste disposal. Solid waste may be plastic or glass or some other metal cans, etc. When these solid waste are disposed of over the land, as such, they may cause soil pollution because these solid pollutants add chemicals to the soil. Okay, besides that, when electrical goods are also discharged as such, like batteries, on the land, then it may also add harmful chemicals to the soil. For example, here I have taken here an example of lithium. Lithium is present in the batteries, and when these batteries are disposed of as such over the land, that lithium may leach down into the soil and may add up into the groundwater, and from there the crops can easily take that lithium and can accumulate that lithium into their tissues and thus produce their toxic effect. Now next is urban activities. In the urban areas, the different activities that mostly go on regularly, like construction activities, and these construction activities adds up various chemicals into the soil. Due to the lack of proper drainage or drainage system, and that may pollute the soil. Besides that, the leakage from the sewerage system in the urban areas may also deteriorate the quality of the soil and cause the soil pollution. Next is acid rain. There are different atmospheric pollutions are there, like sulfur oxides, nitrogen oxides. These oxides can easily combine with water vapors and fall back on the ground in the form of acids like nitric acid, sulfuric acid, and these acids can make the land acidic and thus may change the structure of the soil and make the soil unfit for growing crops. Next is accidental oil spills. Oil leakage may take place while storing or transporting the different types of oils, and that mostly happens near the fuel stations, and this fuel can deteriorate the soil quality in the nearby areas and make the soil unsuitable for cultivation of crops. So these and also make the underground water unfit for drinking. So these are different causes of water, soil and air pollution. Thank you.